Hello everyone and thanks for tuning back in. Alessandro the Crypto here. I hope you're doing all fine. Let's have a quick TA on Bitcoin because we had this morning here an initial test of this resistance here of $9,200 and we came up here to $9,240 and so far we are getting rejected here. The thing is that it looks like that we could build up here some nice support and some nice pressure here to the upside. We are currently here in the 1 hour trading above the 20 moving average, RSI back above the 50, RSI coming to oversold condition, and although if we have a look on the Bollinger Band, we are now back here in bullish mode here in the 1 hour time frame. MACD could have a bearish cross here, but this is what we're going to have to see here in the next couple of hours if this will have an impact here on the price or not, because currently it looks like that Bitcoin could have here a potential breakout to the upside. I'm still leaning more to the bullish mode, even though I think there is a very high chance that we could see here a potential dump towards the 200 daily moving average at around $8,500. But the traditional markets today opened so far quite nicely. Also, the S&P 500 mini futures are looking quite nice. We still have some upwards momentum here, even though we could be in a potential rising wedge here, which technically is a bearish pattern, and we could see a breakout here to the downside, and in that case we could see a possible $3,100 retest. But this is just in the 1 hour time frame. In the bigger time frames, also the S&P 500 mini futures are looking pretty bullish, and that's why this could also signal that maybe on Bitcoin we could see a potential breakout here to the upside, because also this support down here at around $9,000 currently is still a very strong support, and we also had here the confirmation that currently this yellow line is still holding as a very strong support, and we should see here a potential breakout from this bigger falling wedge that we are in currently. And now let's go over to the 4 hour time frame, because also here you can see that currently we're trading above the 20 moving average in the 4 hour, which is very important for a breakout here. So in theory now we shouldn't close any 4 hour candle again below 9,170. Otherwise, this could indicate that we will see another $9,070 test and then potentially also break it to the downside. But here in the 4 hour, again, we are more bullish than bearish because we are testing now the 200 moving average and we're having the 20 as a support. RSI again above the 50 level, and the stochastic here is potentially coming down to neutral condition. Right now it's quite overbought, but here also it looks like that in case that here the $9,170, the 20 moving average is holding as a support, we could see a potential breakout to the upside. The problem is that so far, even here with this little fake out here, we didn't see any volume kicking in. So also keep an eye on the volume in case of a breakout, because so far it's still very, very boring here. We don't have any volume, nothing. No one is trading right now. Even me, I have no trade nowhere, not on BTR, not on Bybit, nowhere. I have no trade open because I just don't see why we should put in a trade right now. But as I told you also in the previous videos, make sure that you're ready to trade it, because the next move will be huge and we're still waiting here, and it looks like that we could maybe even see an initial pump here and the breakout of this falling wedge, and this would kick us straight towards $10,000. So this is more, or let's say that's around 10% to the upside, and if you go with leverage you can do very nice gains in here. And let's also have a quick look on the Bollinger Band in the 4 hour time frame, because also here you can see after overshooting it to the upside, we are retracing back down. So if we have a retest here of this 9,160 level here, the midline of the Bollinger Band, we should have the confirmation that we could see an initial breakout here to the upside in the next couple of hours or days. And here also the MACD shifted to the upside. So in the 4 hour, everything is still very bullish. If we go over to the daily, here you can see the bearish side of this attempt here to break it, because we just topped out here at the 20 daily moving average. So this is still bearish. The only positive thing here is that we are still fighting here the 20 daily moving average, and so far we didn't see a major crash down. So this is in theory a good thing, because the more we test it, the weaker this moving average gets, and then we could see a breakout here towards 9,500 and then potentially also towards $10,000. That would be our target in case of a breakout here to the upside. So first 9,500, and as soon as we're gonna break this area again, then $10,000, because that's the top of this channel that we are in currently. And also here you see that the RSI is trading below the 50. So only if we're able to bring the RSI again above the 50 and also start to close daily candles above the 20 daily, so above 9,220, then I think we should be good to go to have a big push to the upside. But as long as we're trading here in the daily below the 50 level, and also we are not able to close daily candles above the 20 daily moving average, in theory, for the lower time frames, even though you see a potential pump, wait for a daily close, because even though we could see a couple of hours the price trading again above 9,200, maybe even get rejected here at $9,400 to $9,500 level, we could immediately retrace back down and then see the big crash here towards the 200 daily moving average, which currently is down here at around $8,500. So for the lower time frames, we could see a possible push here to the upside, but important is that in the daily we're starting to close these candles again above the 20 daily and not below the 20 daily moving average. And also if you go over to the Bollinger Band, you can see that currently we are getting here some problems with breaking through the middle line. So as soon as we can close a daily candle in the upper area here, then we should be good to go and also retest here this $9,400 level. But as long as we are not able to close daily candles above the midline of the Bollinger Band, in theory we could fall again easily towards this $9,000 support that we have currently. MACD is also still flat here, so also here in the daily in the MACD we are waiting for a possible move to the upside or to the downside, potentially more now to the upside, even though the 20 daily moving average is still giving us resistance. But if we switch over here into the weekly, you can see that currently we are in theory still very bullish here in the bigger time frames. You see here the RSI above the 50, stochastic nicely coming down again to cool off here in neutral territory. The 20 weekly moving average, which is the most important moving average in a bull run, which is currently at $8,800. This is the line that you have to watch, and also that we have to close weekly candles above, because in case that we're going to start to close weekly candles below this moving average, then we could see a bigger long-term trend reversal. But as long as we are closing weekly candles above this moving average, like we also did here last week, everything is still good and we should in theory start to trade here to the upside and have a potential big breakout from this $10,000 resistance. Because once we're gonna break here this red line here, I think we could be start to see again prices above $10,000 to retest 14, 16, 18, and most likely even this year $20,000. But this is what we're gonna have to see if we are able to break this $10,000 resistance. Alright guys, and with that said, I'm going to wrap it up for now. This was a quick TA. We're basically still trading at the same place for the last couple of weeks, and we're just waiting for this big breakout, and that's why make sure that you're ready to trade. If you don't know where you can trade, then watch the video that is popping up at the end of this video where it says Bitcoin Leverage Trading Exchanges. And also if you need the links, you find them all down below here in the video description. With my links you can get some sign up bonus, and also you support the channel. Make sure also to tune in our free Discord trading chat. We have a great community over there, so shout out to all the members. And I do the live streams over on Twitch, so make sure also to join me over on Twitch. And of course, leave a like here, subscribe to the channel. We do weekly $10 worth of Bitcoin giveaways, and the new subscription video for this week is coming up later. So make sure to sign up to our weekly giveaway today. The video is coming later on today, and that's why make sure to subscribe here to the channel, leave a like, and tune in every day. Alright my friends, thank you very much for watching. Best regards from Italy. I'm traveling now to the beach, and we're gonna see us over there. Bye!